Joining me now is Dr. Cornel West, professor of philosophy at Harvard, and Candace Owens, conservative commentator and founder of the Blexit movement. Dr. West, should African Americans maybe look twice about their support for Joe Biden, given some of these past issues?
Well, I think, one, that Brother Biden is no dummy. He's got fine energy. But his big problem is that he is a die-in-the-wool, backward-looking neoliberal with little vision and even less courage. And so in that sense, he represents a past. And I know he's got the Obama halo, but that is going to decline. And I don't see Barack Obama. I don't see Brother Barack breakdancing in support of Biden either. So I think we really got to take a look at my brother. You got to take a look at Bernie Sanders. Vision, courage, consistency. And you'll see tomorrow the way in which the legacy of FDR and Martin Luther King Jr., Albert Einstein, Helen Keller, all of those great human beings.
I mean, throw in a few more there, Cornell.
Yes.
Thomas
Norman
Edison.
Thomas, Michael Harrington, okay. Barbara Ehrenreich,
right.
Stanley
okay,
Aronowitz. We can go on and on. Yes, indeed.
But I think Cornell makes an interesting point here, because we were just talking about vitality and age and, you know, people age in different ways and so forth. But Bernie Sanders, who's 77, to me, and putting aside looks and all that, to me seems a lot younger than Joe Biden. I mean, he's charging. He's like out there. I mean, you can't help but watch Bernie Sanders when he's out there. Candace, it's an interesting point, though, because Biden is way up over Trump among black voters. Does the Trump team need to sell their achievements better? What can they do to make up some of that difference? Let's say Biden does get the nomination.
You know, I definitely always think that you can communicate the points better, and definitely this administration can talk about what they are doing better. But you're not going to find disagreement right now with me and Dr. West when it comes to Joe Biden. I think that his history and race has been absolutely abhorrent, and Trump should hit hard on that. We know exactly what he's done in the past. We know that he championed the crime bill of 94. He really pushed that through. We also know that we see a lot of black Americans talking about the disparities in terms of sentencing when it comes to crack versus powder cocaine, and that was also championed by Joe Biden. This information isn't out enough, and that's part of the problem, and we need to make sure that the Trump administration does get that information forward. Now, of course, we always do have to disagree, Dr. West, and I would disagree with you in terms of thinking that Joe Biden is a candidate that we should be going for. I mean, yes, he is a more enthusiastic character than Joe Biden, but he's talking about socialism, and we know that
Sanders,
is something
Bernie,
that has, Bernie, that is absolutely destroyed and decimated the black community, socialist policies, like in terms of the welfare. So a little bit of agreement here, but mostly.
Yeah, but Cornell, you think that Bernie Sanders is going to deliver, what, a better economy than Trump for African Americans? Because I haven't heard that argument for Bernie. I've heard a lot about giveaways. But how is he going to raise the actual standard of living, the wage-earning capacity of all Americans, including African Americans, who have been disproportionately hit by open borders and the lowering of wages because of a huge influx of indigent workers?
Oh, but no, my dear sister, you asked the workers at Walmart, who are of all colors. So we're talking about humanity. We're talking about Americans across race at this point. You ask the workers at Walmart whether they will be able to live a life of more decency under a Sanders administration as opposed to a Trump administration. He was just there in Arkansas, standing with the workers, McDonald's workers too. He stands with working people and poor people. That's his connection to Martin King. That's his connection to FDR. That's his connection to Fannie Lou Hamer. And so, my dear sister Candace, I would argue that welfare again now was not socialist. It was an attempt to intervene, given the failure of capitalism to provide jobs of a living wage for people. It was not socialistic at all.
It was absolutely socialist, and you know that. And
no,
you know that our community, after the first 100 years, doctor, come on.
That's not socialist.
100 years after slavery, the black community was doing better. We were going up, up, up. Then suddenly they socialized our community via welfare policies, and the black community started going down. down. And you're sitting here supporting a candidate that is advocating for making that on a larger scale. He's saying, we're not just going to do it to the black community. We're going to do it to every community in America.
Well,
you know his policies do not work. You know that socialism has led to more deaths than anything else in the last 100 years. 100 million deaths, and you stand behind this man. You should not. You need to stand behind Trump because he is getting standing next to poor people and making poor people richer are two different things.
All right, let's get
the very fact that you have been able to aspire and achieve the level that you have based on the struggle of those who came before, from W.B. Du Bois, from Ida B. Wells, to Frederick Douglass, they were not concerned with isms. They were concerned with justice and fairness. Now, Du Bois was a socialist, but he wasn't pro-welfare. So you got to get your history right,
Frederick
my dear
Douglass.
Sister.
Well, we're talking about Bernie Sanders. We don't have to talk about history. We're talking about present. We're talking about Bernie Sanders and what he's offering to the black community, which is awful.
When Richard Smalls of South Carolina, when Frederick Douglass called for public schools, he was called
Bernie
a socialist.
Sanders,
he was talking about fairness.
Doctor, we're talking about
Bernie Sanders. Bernie Sanders is part of the legacy. Bernie Sanders is part of that legacy, Sister Candace. That's what I'm trying to get you to see. But it's not welfare. It has nothing to do with welfare. It has to do with fairness, jobs with a living wage. It has to do with workers' control in some sense at the workplace.
This is basic economics. Everything can't be free.
We've got to quit spreading these lies. Quit spreading these lies about what socialism is. I'm telling you.
Okay, we're tight on time here, but I still say Cornell and Candace both have to go to the Oval Office. And Cornell, you have to just spend some time with Trump, with Candace. Okay?
I'll take you.
I'll just sit and have popcorn and watch it. But I'm telling you, you have to spend some time with him. Throw away your preconceived ideas. I'm telling you.
I'm a jazz. I'm a jazz man. I believe in improvisation and engaging with dialogue with anybody.
Good.
I just want people to get the facts right and the truths right and make sure we're concerned about poor and working people.
It's not the ism
at this point.
All right.
According to Sister Candace, Jesus would be a socialist. Was Jesus a socialist?
Brother West.
Was Jesus a socialist?
You know that what's going on.
All right, guys, we
gotta
go. We gotta go. Great conversation. We can do an hour together.
We have spent more time.
And Cornell, I didn't mean to say Harvard that way. That's just the dark.